Hi, I'm Sascha on bass. Do you know about noodling when you're improvising? Noodling is when you play random notes that don't really relate to each other and the audience or anyone does not understand what you want to say. When you're noodling, your solo or comping can sound like random notes or even worse. Today I want to give you a quick tip how you can overcome noodling. There are a lot of tricks, and today I want to talk about pauses and separation of phrases or development of phrases. A phrase in music is the same like in verbal language. A phrase can be seen as a sentence, a short combination of notes or impulses. So one sentence or phrase can be a statement. A group of phrases can be a story. So if you try to give groups of phrases meaning or relation, you can say more with the notes you play. So here's an exercise for you. Try to improvise over a modal vamp. Play to a backing track or to a song. Whatever you like, whatever you feel comfortable with. And you stay only within that scale you choose or the key you're choosing. Now play short phrases of 3 to 6 notes. Then pause. Take your time and play a new phrase. And be inspired by the phrase you played before. Try to relate them to each other. Set another pause. Play another phrase from a different point in the scale. And let's say in the fourth phrase you're playing, you try to resolve to the root note or maybe to the third. Here's an example playing ascending notes within a scale. So this is very easy to hear because we're going the scale downwards and it's a fairly easy way to start with. Here's an example when you play random notes within the scale. Here's an example where you can use triads within that scale. So with this exercise, it's important that you take your time for each phrase. Make every phrase as simple as possible and as clear as possible. It doesn't matter if you play only 3 notes, you can even play 1 note or just 2 notes and make the change only rhythmically. Try to play with the pauses you set. Give the pauses meaning, so the next phrase you are playing is even more meaningful and makes sense with all the other phrases you played before or after. Try to resolve in the fourth one. And then start a new cycle of groups. Now I will give you an example over a song by Chia called Planet Chia. The song is in E harmonic minor. And there are 2 chords in this section. It's B7, B9, B13, which is the 5th degree of harmonic minor, E harmonic minor, and A7, sharp 11, which is the 4th degree of harmonic minor. Thank you. So I hope this little trick is useful for you. You can change everything up, use different scales. You can even go with just triads or chords. It's important that you keep every phrase separate and develop them from one another. If you play pauses, I want to encourage you to take even longer pauses than you would usually did. So, that's it. Have lots of fun with this little exercise and see you next time. Bye. The book.